We had Verilog in our third sem, but then actually we didn't like it that time. When we did this project, we started liking it. In our college, due to the pandemic, even that course got halted a little bit. So based on that, we couldn't actually understand the nice things about FPGA or the all the good stuff about FPGA, how powerful it is. But then due to this project, now we really like it and we want to continue doing projects on this as well. So it just showed us that Arduino and Raspberry Pi is not the only thing. Even FPGA can be used for robotics very well.
Whatever the code that you are writing for protocols and everything, be sure to go through the data sheet before actually implementing it. In our I2C, we had done everything perfectly working, but we didn't give low to one register. One pin was not assigned, so it was not working. We made a lot of testing for that, and later we got to know that.
We first used breadboards to make all the connections. So this was one thing which we should have avoided from the beginning. We faced a lot of loose connections. In hardware, loose connections are a total, they just spoil everything. Loose connections are very hard to debug. Everything must be soldered. If there are a few sensors which are dependent on light, you must make sure that you have an encasing for them or something, or maybe you close the curtains in the daylight and so that you can mimic the night time and you can have the same working throughout the day.
Testing the wires before actually soldering, sometimes we add problems in our wires and not the code nor the FPGA. So that was actually where's the problem, and we cut the wires, and when we actually threw the wires which were not working, we were that frustrated at that point of time.
It is better to actually keep a testing module for all the sensors, because you don't know when a sensor goes out. It's very difficult to debug. Keep a module ready for that. And in case if the components are not very much expensive, our FPGA board was 8,000 to 9,000, so that was expensive. The normal other components, maybe color sensor and line sensor, which are less than 500, it's better to keep a spare with you. So if anything wrong happens, you can just test with the other one and get to know what's the real issue.
And while we're trying to debug any sort of code, one thing that we did was we used a lot of flag variables. We kept on using them everywhere, just so that we can at least figure out what went wrong and where or what. Other than that, I think one more thing is to test if any equipment on the board is heating up or what. And for the motor and all, until we got a proper timer, we had to keep on testing and just to check if it's overheating or what.
Best thing that is coming out of this competition is that consistency as well as commitments. So when we have deadlines, we actually give our best. So it's one of the good things. If we are doing self project, we'll procrastinate. So this project shows the actual potential of a person if they participate in this competition. So that's the biggest takeaway of this competition. Doing this project will get a more research-oriented mind rather than do-your-work kind of mind. Everyone is getting the same theme, but then everyone can implement in a very different way and innovative way as they wish to. We have to search the net, and then we have to get the proper understanding of the data sheet or the algorithm, and then we have to code it up ourselves. Actually, for us, FPGA, we didn't get any research online. Only one textbook was there. Even the textbook, we had to read it ourselves, the parts we need. Innovation is one thing that is good. If only academics was there, we would have all procrastinated. Since this is also there, we were actually worried about oh my God, we have tests. If we didn't have this project, we would be oh, I still have time to study. So that attitude is now gone, and we actually now know that we can multitask and then do well in both.
Before taking up Yantra, I was not a very good a believer of project-based learning kind of thing. I was more into theory concept. There was a gap that I could see between the theory and the actual working. So Yantra has really helped me to fill that bridge very well. And now I feel that I'm confident in maybe making projects and working on real hardware.